everybody here to the Kiev Major European Qualifiers game. Two of three, potentially three, Team Secret going up against Alliance. I'm Toby One. I am joined by the one, the only, the Woo.
So flattering.
Team Secrets turn.
You are
to
the one,
bad.
The only. I don't think there's another caster like you. Maybe Sindarin.
Poor Sindarin.
My two favorite co-casters.
Maybe he's coming back. I don't actually know. We can all hope.
If he ever retires, which he won't.
5 seconds remaining.
He won't. You know he won't.
It's really hard to retire from Dota.
How did you manage to do it?
I had to pay bills.
Well, there was no money back when you were playing Dota. Yeah. Now there is money, and Veggie's won the qualifier. You could have been
forfeited, dude.
You could have been it. You won the qualifier and then forfeited.
Dude, one of the funniest things was Cap tweeted out that some guy had messaged him. He's like, "You guys had an offensive GG, but you forgot to cancel it. What the hell?" It was so funny, actually. I was cracking up laughing. I was like, the guy was completely serious too, but it was.
Oh, he may have only been watching through Dota TV.
Yeah,
and he would have no idea what you guys actually planned.
That was one of the better moments that I had.
Yeah, but man, seriously, professional player coming back soon.
Maybe you TI qualifiers.
Join Team Freedom.
How are they doing, by the way? Do I want it spoiled?
I do not know. But luckily, if you want to go check it out, Beyond the Summit 4, I believe, is running the North American stream at the moment. Of course, you can tune into this one right on Beyond the Summit 2.
We're so smooth at plugging.
Or the mainstream. Hey, I know how to do it, bro. Years of experience of smooth transitions.
Would I describe you as smooth in the top 10 adjectives for Toby?
My transitions are smooth.
Team Secrets,
that is true.
They're only ever made awkward by my co-caster who can't keep up.
Am I making it awkward? I just let you do your thing, dude.
No, I was actually waiting for you to make it awkward before, so you say smooth transition and then it'll be a really awkward thing.
No, it was quite smooth.
Yeah, you had my back. I'm not used to that. Stop giving me support. I'm not allowed to have.
I have a lot of trouble giving compliments. Actually, I was like, "Oh wow, that was really nice," and people were like, "Oh, that was rude." I was like, "What?"
Like, sarcasm.
Yeah,
right? But you can't get the tone right.
I was like, "No, I thought that was genuinely pretty nice." They're like, "Oh, it didn't sound like it." I don't know.
You have that tone of like. You can be rather condescending.
I know.
With your tone. Even though it's not meaning to be, it can be very condescending.
But what if it's a compliment?
It's still hard, because most people can never handle compliments very well.
Oh.
Some people can, but normally they're egotistical pricks. I don't handle compliments very well, but I'm very egotistical.
As long as you realize it.
I accept my faults. Okay, so... Let's look at the draft. What faults do we find?
Let's see. Secret, they definitely aren't going to change the bans up because they won.
Alliances turn to true.
Their bans have been really good, though. Like, the way they manhandled everyone through the playoffs has been, I think, actually through their drafting. Mm-hmm. NIP was made quick work of with a lone druid ban. An Alliance, they know better. Yes, Secret can play Lone Druid. You best ban it out, as has every single other team in the playoffs. Actually, I think they did ban it yesterday.
Yeah, they did.
Yeah,
they did.
They learned.
Lone Druid very rarely got through. But maybe they just thought they could handle it this time around. Or it was the gamble, right? Like, they took the Io and gave up the Lone Druid.
Io didn't do anything. If anything,
yeah,
you
really
take
did.
Lone Druid, but...
Yeah, we mentioned that at the end of the last game. It's like, so what was EGM synergizing with again?
He was supposed to stack for the for the Alchemist. He was supposed to buff up his network.
Yeah, but that happened once.
He was supposed to keep stacking all game, but the game got really hectic because Secret had a game plan. They're really good at invading the jungle. I think that is one of Team Secret's biggest strengths.
Yeah.
Did that sound condescending?
No, not at all.
Okay, see?
That was perfect, man.
Better.
You're looking good. You're sounding
but
great.
The thing is, if it's like out of the blue... And if it's not, if I don't transition it,
but you do have that thing of like you just don't talk for a while, and then you'd be like, "You're really good." No, really, you're really good.
That was really good.
That's my bed.
That was a good bed.
My bed
impersonation.
Turn to pick. All right, so
you've hung around me too often.
Yeah, said I'm going back to Europe. You can stay in America. Still follow me around to events. All right, so Team Secret, no Enigma, no Omni Knight, and we get a Skywrath Mage. Alliance did great things against a Timbersaw, actually, with this guy in combination with the Centaur. But both of those heroes have been banned.
What? Secret Abba?
Is this a 1 or a 3?
Almost certainly a 3. I think it's just replacing the Omni Knight because Omni and Enigma got banned out. The thing is, they also can play Tide. Like, I don't really think you can ban out Kezu, although you can try. But Secret were very fast with their response. Abba is very difficult for Skywrath to deal with. It's really hard to harass him. It's really hard to... You can't kill him with Mystic Flare because his ult will always trigger.
Yeah.
And if you don't go on him, he just shields off the Ancient Seal. So it's not a worthy matchup for him. However, Skywrath is pretty good at roaming if they do want to mess with the IO, as Pileidae has been jungling on the Dire side with Iron Talon.
But can they stop him? Can they actually stop him with what they've got? Because you're running an ET and Skywrath.
Skywrath is really good at level 1 roam. He's very fast, and he does a ton of damage at level 1. He's kind of ideal, I would say, for that sort of scenario.
So then we look to Team Secret to play more of a buffer role or someone who's more active in the mid.
Or they just have really strong lanes so that Skywrath is forced to help the lanes out. That's another option. Abba is a menace.
Well, because how are you meant to run the bottom lane if Skywrath Mage isn't always there? Like, it has to turn to ET to roam,
yeah,
right?
You can have ET zone, but that means you also need the Ember Spirit to have a good matchup in mid. So, like, Alliance are starting to have slight lane issues.
Faceless Void.
Okay.
Faceless Void, Skywrath, old school.
Is this 3, then Faceless Void?
I would assume Loda.
Unless you run it like Ember mid, Faceless, safe lane then, right? Okay.
Yeah, I think Ember mid, Faceless, safe lane. They do have the IO to relocate out. And the Abba, who is really good against Chronosphere.
Yeah, and like then, like what? You look to the Faceless Void to do enough damage during the middle of his Chronosphere? Most of the Faceless Voids I've been watching take too long to build up that damage output.
Oh, he's not the damage. ET and Skywrath are.
That's it.
Yo, that's old school combo. Remember Faceless Elder Titan being first picked every single game?
Yeah.
It's still decently strong, not as strong, but it's still pretty strong.
It seems harder to synergize against what Secret have.
It's also hard because everyone's... man.
Really?
That's dirty.
Really? Okay.
Oh, man.
Welcome to the party, Team Secret. Abaddon, Huskar, Io.
They can destroy this Faceless Void in lane if they wanted to. Io, Huskar versus Faceless Void.
You have to put him third, right? Or is this if the Huskar's in the safe lane?
He's going to crush whatever matchup he's up against.
I assume the Huskar will go with the Io to the mid. Or Huskar will be solo bid, and Iron Talon, Pileidae will be level 4, level 5, and then join the Huskar.
I wonder if they consider throwing ET as the position 3, and Faceless Void as the position 1, so they can draft AA. I think AA is, like, maybe the only way they can actually deal with the Huskar. Because Timbersaw has been banned out already by Team Secret. Anyways, MP Secret still out. Alliance fearful of the Terrorblade, although I don't think Terrorblade would have done very well here. Elder Titan does very well versus Skywrath.
They banned
out the AA. Team okay.
so no rotating lanes and then Legion Commander. So more sustain across the board. You've got individual lockdown as well.
What is good against good old Huskar? I don't remember all the Huskar counters because I haven't seen that hero in a very long time. His talents are lackluster, actually. I did play him a couple times, and it was never a wow. Worst versus Chaos Knight, PL, and AA.
Reserve time.
Could they fit any of those in their lineup? CK, perhaps? CK is actually pretty good here. Legion Commander, overwhelming odds is damage versus illusions. Extra damage, but not that much.
10 seconds remaining.
And it is a Loda hero, but Faceless Void position 3, I think you might have to do something like that.
Okay.
Luna is tough. There is no save for the Luna. There's no SD, there's no Dazzle, there's no Omni Knight.
The only save is the Stomp.
That is...
And a Chrono, potentially.
I wouldn't even consider a Stomp a save.
Well, you can't heal through it. What's he going to do? Hold on to Fairy Fire and hope that's going to be enough to regenerate through 8 Burning Spears?
I'm not sure.
Yeah, I'm not sure either. You said that Team Seeker has been on top of the draft for most of this qualifier. In the last game that they have to win. Now, if they win this, they go to Kiev. And right now, their draft looks very much set to take them to Kiev. Man, Alliance will need some magical thing to happen. And I assume it's going to be with them being aggressive.
They can dodge the lanes.
Yeah, so run the Luna top, put the Faceless Void bottom, and where that? Am I even in the map? Oh, I'm on a mountain. Thanks. I love this. Yep. It's a game.
So where do they want the Luna to go? The Luna needs to have a really good game.
Look at that swagger step. Look at that.
He's pretty sweet. He
needs like some kind of like that's a rap video move
Does
right
he have
there.
The immortal help? Can you check out his items?
I will, but after his swagger step. Oh yeah, look at that swagger.
Oh yeah, he doesn't have the immortal.
Okay. 7 godlike sprees on this one.
That's a lot, because Huskar's very hard to get godlike sprees. He has to play like 7,000 games to get godlike sprees with him. Actually,
everything else is pretty uncommon though.
Huskar was popular at one point. I don't remember whether or not it was. When
let me check out the IO set. Oh wait, why is his name that?
That is not the hero that won the Arcana tour.
Hang on. Why is that name not the official name? Isn't their sponsor? 419 dual wins. I'm okay with that.
Oh, he doesn't have the unlocked chaotic wins. Sad. I don't have them unlocked. I don't know how to get them.
I don't know. I have a wonderful one, but it's called it's time to do. That's mine.
What's that?
Yu-Gi-Oh.
Oh, I don't know. I'm not a Yu-Gi-Oh boy.
How do you just?
Sorry. Pop culture references and me don't mix, Toby.
How can you consider yourself a gamer?
Because I don't play Yu-Gi-Oh? I'm a Dota fanatic, man. The battle begins.
I'm happy to sit in my one little world. Alright, so we look at MPs, but going to build a little bit of extra strength early on. Magic Wand, Boots. It's going up against Limp, who'll be in the mid lane as the Ember Spirit, probably the only person who could lane against him in the early phases. Flame Guard, protect me.
No. No way. Dude, Burning Spears is ridiculous amounts of damage. 5 damage a second times 8 seconds. So 2 Burning Spears can take off level 1 Flame Shield.
Okay, let's watch it. 1, 2.
Yeah, I mean, he's not going to catch
3.
That's just a waste of mana, dude.
4.
Okay, so they actually have swapped up the lanes, though.
Rack him. Stack him. Pack him. Oh, wait. MP. Very aggressive. Pilot Eye doesn't have a lot of heal to work with. He's going to munch in a tango. But as he does that, he loses the tether connection.
Oh, Onskin. Coming in from behind.
He needs to help out. But Pilot Eye has now got his bottle, so you can try and help out all you want. Every 2 minutes, Pilot Eye is going to have more and more mana coming your way. And even Hanskin, the wings are on fire.
This is cool, though, that Secret have swapped up the lanes. Mid one into the safe lane and the MP in the mid. It's not something that I've seen before, but they're exerting a lot of flexibility in this draft.
It's funny because we were talking about it during game one, where they're very, very set in their ways. I think EGM is looking for the perfect stomp. As he's going to come in, let it go over on Puppy. You don't have Lucent Beam is now up, and EGM is going to try and punch through him, but with no Spirit buff up, it's more harassment than anything else against the Rubick. Not real kill potential. How's the bottom lane looking? Keizu versus Unison Farm. The Abaddon versus Faceless Void. That seems like a very sad place for a Faceless Void to be.
It is. He has level 2 Curse of Avernus up already. Happy to right click him, bounce up, pretty much.
I don't feel like I could take my eyes off the mid. Paladar's unlucky with the rune. It's going to be down on bottom in a double damage rune. Which, luckily for Limp, Huntskin is right on top of. But this top lane is looking so aggressive with the way EGM is moving. But on the bottom lane, you can't count out the Abaddon. Like, he's going for a 0-1-2 build, so his physical, like, fighting whenever Unison Farm approaches the creep wave is just so damn strong.
And the damage is also very spread out. He can't actually time walk out of anything here except for Life Ring. I think they were kind of set in the Face of the Void after the first couple of picks. They're like, oh, okay, ET. Yeah, we picked Skywrath. Okay, we need something to set up for it. And they really wanted it, despite it not being terribly great for the Secrets lineup. A lot of counters to Karnos here.
Stomp's coming in, but it's too far away. Even then, Lotus too busy farming underneath the tower. But I'm looking at the top three CSs, and every single one of them is coated in red. Team Secret is well on top. It's 8-4 up against a 12-4. And Yuzen Farm is dying. He has to time walk off the damage.
And Abba has access to the shrine in case he needs it.
I haven't even seen MP really like go ham. He's keeping the Flame Guard stacks up over on Limp. As you said, the Flame Guard can't survive that long, so it's all about the burning spears.
But Pilot Eye does switch it up sometimes. Not Iron Talon in jungle this game. But
that's true.
Very difficult to see us in the mid.
But yeah, if he stays with the mid, like what are they even meant to do against that either? Like it's just Huskar doing Huskar things.
Pilot Eye and Puppy smoked up.
Ooh, that's a lonely level 1 Fae boss, not a hell of a lot of damage. And they do see Hanskin just sitting around the top room for the 4-minute rune. Now, there is no rune, but MP's copying a lot of damage. Now, Paladai comes in, Puppy, looking for the lift on Limp. Can't actually get him up. And he'll get back in range of the T1 tower, but the Burning Spears have done the work. Paladai with the extra balls helped out too, but the Storm, the Tether away! The Orb is flying in. Don't think it's enough damage for Pilot Eye to die, and yeah, it won't be. 31 HP will survive on, and then gets a rune to boot.
That was a nice toggle of the overcharge. It wouldn't have mattered. Yeah, 34 HP left, but it was still nice to see. He toggled the overcharge right as soon as the Arcane Bolt hit.
Pilot has got another rune as well. So Puppy and Pilot Eye team up together, and they're solo killing the Sky... Well, I say dual killing the Skywrath Mage. The solo Skywrath.
Pilot Eye is really good about the spirits, by the way. He is extremely good about getting a lot of damage on those. This is why we saw like the
Jesus diving.
Oh yeah, this is not great.
Is the run again? The TP support's coming in. They want to find a kill now. Pana doesn't have a lot of mana to work with, but Keizu, he's still not level 6 yet. So Puppy, Teleki just throwing EGM around. Unisa Farm gets the leap away. Pilei die needs 2 seconds before he can tether. Then he can jump up to Keizu and kill the tree line off. Now Limp's coming in as well. Abaddon, he needs help. Unisa Farm is so low. Their stomp is creating space, but not enough. It's still a 1-for-1 trade-off until Pilei die will eventually fall down to Limp. The Flame Guard doing the last bit of burn.
4 heroes there trying to protect their safe lane. Lota left all alone up top versus a level 6 Legion Commander. Io level 4.5. I mean, he doesn't need Iron Talent to get his levels. Because they're getting plenty and plenty of kills. I believe he got the solo XP on that Ember in the mid lane. And Pilot Eye did a really good job of also spending his gold before he died. So he's actually doing quite well in terms of net worth. Whereas Skywrath,
their lane
no
switching.
Boots.
Loda knows he can't stay here anymore.
It's way too dangerous.
Yeah. So you send the Faceless Void in. Need a fair amount of burst damage, but then again, how... Okay, so Pilot Eye with his farm is probably going to hit 5.5 soon. With level 6 bringing friends.
Limp can still do a lot. If they can actually kill the Wisp very early on in the fights, I think they have a pretty good shot of killing the Huskar. Or just kiting him with like stomps and whatnot until his support crew
absolutely
dies by the wayside.
Not.
What do you think about the fact that Keizu hasn't leveled his ulti yet? Like, is he holding it just in case level 1 Mist Coil is enough to get a kill?
Perhaps. He doesn't need it right now, it doesn't do anything.
Legion's now on bottom lane. So, while you may have rotated Faceless Void to the top lane, he may have Chrono. Oh, actually, TP's off cooldown already. So if the fight does blow up on bottom lane, they can just run in. But the Observer Ward's already there. Smoke's going to break in mid one, looking for that high movement speed. They're chasing Loda, but the seal is on Keizu. Where's your TP support? Boy's not coming. It's 4 heroes together, and the duel victor is actually claimed. Mid one will get the bonus damage, but it was Keizu who got the last hit in.
Dire had used scan, too. They used scan to the northwest of the tower to see how many heroes were there, and they just immediately ran in. Kazu level 7.
Spirits, they need the Searing Chains off. ET Spirits down. They want to bring in Luna so you can at least get that Lucid Beam off with a Concussive Shot, but MP alive. Puppy made a little bit of space, but can he make more? MP can't tank through that full Eclipse. They let the Chronosphere go too, over towards the Rubick, and they have enough damage. Both heroes going down. You still lose your Tier 1 tower, and you had to bring 5 heroes in to do this, but a kill is a kill, and a roll is a roll.
They've slowed down Huskar a lot. He bought Treads before the Armlet. That's actually not that common. I see Brown Boots Armlet far more often on the Huskar. I think it actually would have saved him in that scenario. Actually, maybe not. I don't think he could toggle through the Eclipse. But
maybe also just confidence in the lane.
Yeah.
That they can't attack him while Pilot Eye is there.
It's very strong, though. Especially when you have Abba, you cast a shield, and then you can Armlet toggle pretty safely through very small damage ticks, like Flame Guard, for example, Mystic Flare, even.
They're giving MP the space now up on top lane to get to finish up that Armlet.
They're getting really good about getting towers, though. Like, they have hit towers constantly. Bottom tower is already down, Abba especially good at that, and mid tower already getting threatened, whereas Alliance have yet to approach it. They're still trying to stave off this Wisp movement in the early game. Pilot Eye, just a couple experience away from level 6, still cannot relocate anyone in, but be on the lookout for duos around the map.
The mid one wants it. He knows there's no flame guy because he's being burned by an invisible force before. But he's still not going to take the risk. Especially when you don't have a Faceless Void to jump in with Chrono to save. Okay. Here's free gold. Kazu. Hanskin knows it as well. He can't outrun an Abaddon.
Kazu's very heavy on this bottom lane. And he's gonna have Helmet on pretty soon.
Why does it just seem like Kazu has these immortal heroes like 10-15 minutes in? Obviously the Abaddon is a lot more immortal earlier on, but like when you had the Enigma and you get the mech up and running, it was almost impossible to kill him off.
Puppy always sets him up for success, either giving him like a free jumbo to work with while he deals with the off lane, or gives him a really good matchup in the off lane. I think he drafts really well for this.
Pilot.
Wow.
The duel was gonna come in. And it was going to be a straight tether from Pilot Eye and a life break from MP. Would have been a guaranteed death on Limp. Now he leaves the defensive spirit up so he can TP back to regen.
Armless up on MP right now. And if they don't do something about it, it's just going to be like TO1 after TO1 and a Roshan. I guess Elder Titan is a little bit good at stopping these pushes. And part of the reason why Alliance draft is so often for their team. But
it can slow it down, but he can't stop it. Like, yeah. Limp turns on the Flame Guard, you know MP still wants a piece of this. At the moment he focuses on the tower, Pilot Eye will help him out with that.
Faceless Void coming in around from the left side, will he get hit?
It's going to be a huge chrono here if we can get it. Limp is caught in the middle of it, the tower's already gone down.
He got hit by the spirits. So they knew that he was up there.
So no opening. But Loda has space on bottom lane to farm. I say that, he TP's out instantly. Puppy will arrive on bottom lane to stop the push. And instead of actually moving to bottom lane straight, Team Secret will rotate into the jungle.
They're pretty happy with the farm that they're getting right now. 2 towers, 4,000 net worth gold lead for Secret. Not that much dual damage on the Legion Commander, but they still are using their Huskar very, very well. And Kezu can also scale out as a core in case it goes a little bit later. I wonder what build he's going to do on the Huskar after. Looks like Morbid Mask. I see a lot of Solar Crest slash like Halberd stacking onto him, because usually you just have physical damage. So
he could do that
armor
and still just have the casual Morbid Mask turn into a Satanic later.
Oh, definitely, because I think they need to do Roche. But Alliance's team fight is very potent around the Roshan pit.
It may be they're saving Grace through the Void.
Yep.
But you see what the Void's building into as well. Like anything which keeps the Legion Commander off his back is the Lincoln Sphere. Not even certain if that's going to be for him during the fight, or if he has to give it to Limp.
I think he has to give it to himself. He's a setup for everything. If he gets a good Chronosphere off and dies, he's done his job.
Dire scanning, looking for anyone that may be behind him. Nothing's going to flag for him, however. Sempi still waits for his opportunity on the Ember. Wonder if Ember can even bait the Husker. Because does Spirit break the life break? Depending, like, obviously there's like a range gap, right? But if you have like a Spirit close to the tier 2 tower, maybe you can drag him back.
No.
Yeah. Alright.
It doesn't chase him that quickly. It says it on the tooltip.
It's just it's a range, right?
You gotta press alt.
Okay. 1400. Fair enough. That's still some distance to play with. Fantastic Observer Ward from Team Secret watches Alliance's maneuvering here. And the leap up, the Chronosphere, it's just on the edge. Caught mid one. Eclipse committed as well. The Easy Splitter is down. Puppy cops next for a little bit of the Eclipse and then steals it. He's going to let it go. He does die fairly quickly, however, thanks to the ET Stomp. Keeps Team Secret sleeping. They lost Loader. Now on bottom lane. Pylai die. Alliance are going to capitalize on as much as they possibly can. Three heroes for the price of Loader.
That was a really good Chronos here for Jonas Affair. He got the Rubik at the or the Abba on the edge too, so he couldn't help anyone. Not that I don't think he could have saved them from the Mystic Flare, but it was still a really good Chronos here. And Loader was just in way too deep. You have to expect him to relocate for fights like that. He also was not able to spend his gold on time. Gotta spend your gold, Loader. It's better than buying Midas.
Nothing's better than buying Midas.
There are so many things better than buying Midas. I think that's one of the most important parts of being a core player in general, is micromanaging your unreliable moves.
Mid one's looking for the duel. He was hoping ET was just sitting at the tower, but EGM was just a little bit further back. Meanwhile, Alliance are rotating towards mid. They really don't want to come into this fight. They know Chrono's still down for another minute, so they try and push in towards the mid tower. Mid one's already starting his rotation. He decided not to build into any kind of maneuverability item.
So Playbell first is quite unusual.
Yeah, no blink, no shadow blade, and hello mid one. Duel, it's going to begin. Pylai Dai is here as well. They got the steal on him. Pylai Dai, he can't even go down. He's still alive, moving down the river. It's the Skywrath, Loader, and Hunskin. He'll take the fall. And it's up to them to actually finish him off. Oh no. Unison Farms on the run. MP already used his life break. Pylai Dai will take a fall and mid one, no duel. So a triple kill for MP. They let him tick out.
Yeah, Puskar is destroying. Luna cannot get cut out like that. He was quite slow on the troll net. Not that it would have mattered. Oh, actually, I think he pressed the attack before going. MP is going to be the tower hitting machine. He can have Curse of Avernus. He has the attacks hitting behind him. He has Overcharge from Wisp. It's a pretty good life for him. Well, he doesn't have Overcharge now.
I don't know if you flagged it or not, but oh wait, no, he does have it. I'm like, his Morbid Mask has appeared from his stash, and that's because he finished both Dragonlance and Morbid Mask.
Yeah, he's mega far. That's 8,000 net worth on your
Husker. 16 minutes in.
Limp has been uncontested, though. He's 3-1-3, and he's gotten a lot of stray pickoffs on Pylai Dai especially. So he is also doing pretty decently in network chart. And I think this is really important. The Ember Spirit can push out the lanes because Luna is not able to do so. Because she just dies very easily if you, like, sneeze at her.
Well, they have an opportunity. MP, leap in, stunt the Chronosphere, he's big, and maybe with the Mystic Flare, the ET Splitter, they have enough damage. Husker will fall.
500 gold EGM.
Buy yourself something nice.
He has a medallion, that's really good versus her liner. Really good against Husker and really good against the LC.
I wonder if he actually affords a Yule Scepter as well, because if he gets that, he can potentially just spin her up during the duel.
Yep, or spin Abba up.
Yep.
So they can focus someone else or during borrowed time. Yeah, Yule's is great here, but I do think the Solar takes precedence just because it's a.
It's Solar Crest. He's looked at it. And he's 450 gold away. He's switched
Solar
up.
Solar Crest is like the caudal of items right now.
The greatest thing, and if you don't get it, you're stupid.
It is so good.
I'm gonna group up in mid. Puppy's got himself two smokes prepared. And they're waiting for the fourth TP in from MP, and that is well away from any Radiant Vision. Both of the Observe Wards from Alliance are committed to looking around the Tier 1 tower at the top, And with this maneuver, because they have the Morbid Mask up, they're jumping in and they're going after Roshan. Alliance have no idea about this.
No Chronosphere anyways. No ETs. Earth Splitter, which I think is like a big deal for a binary like a pit.
No way to stop it.
No way to stop it. But Huskar still has to be able to hit towers. He does have all these buffs behind him, but knocking down those T3s is a different story. People are not going to be able to take down their Burning Spear because of all the shrines available to them. He's going to have to be in a very precarious position.
The smoke breaks. Observer Ward does this work as well as EGN's positioning. He's not moving, however. He's right on top of Dire Observer Ward. Now Puppy, he just ult Echo Stomp. It's not going to be that huge for him. Puppy kills Secures with a Fade Bolt. Just an easy kill for his smoke rotation.
That's the biggest kill, though. Ideally, you'd get Luna, I would say.
She's hanging around mid, trying to hold onto that extra armor by keeping the Wild Wing Ripper right behind her. Top lane, mid one. He's already got a Blink Dagger. Quickly away.
Huskar's now going to finish off that T2 in middle as everyone heads in behind him. Abba way far behind. Looks like he is trying to work on a mech, but it has not been completed just yet.
You almost feel like that harassment works against you. Because every time Ember does that...
...off that T2 in middle as everyone heads in behind him. Abba way far behind. Looks like he is trying to work on a mech, but it has not been completed just yet.
You almost feel like that harassment works against in a way.
Yeah.
He just wants damage out on him, though. Get him in that crucial HP so they can actually combo everyone down, perhaps.
Lymph continues to split push on bottom. MP might get stunned up, but there's just no follow through. Loader is trying to farm with the Wild Wing Rippers and then TP back out again. Staying close enough that he gets the experience, and that's also enough money. I believe he actually can buy up his full Dragon Lance. Yeah, it is. The full Dragon Lance now on the courier. TPing down to the shrine, using the space that Ember Spirit created.
He was farming the enemy neutrals and will be able to TP out.
He's good. Calculated.
They are hard pressed to find farm. Yep. I'm looking for Limp though in the team fight. If Limp can Veil and Triple Remnant the IO, I think that they can actually win the fight off of that, because then they'll be trying to scramble to kill the Ember, and then Jonas the Fan can get a pretty decent Chronosphere. But it all depends on how MP and the rest of Secret play with this Aegis of the Immortal.
Loader needs to get the hell out of here, but he can't. His TP is on cooldown for another 16 seconds. Limp has his own BT, so yeah, he can bail. Mid one's looking for a jump on mid, and that's exactly why Team Secret are already making their way over there. Okay, Loader's still living in fear because he doesn't see where Secret are farming, which is currently just the Ancients, and then we're going to push the mid lane. So he'd love just to force the issue a little bit more on bottom lane. He's just using the Harpy to do it for the moment.
He can't go out because he can just die to relocate.
Yeah,
and he can't TP out in time because he'll just get dueled. So that's not a good place to be if you're a Luna. Might just need to get a Manta style so you can push out without fear of losing your body and hero.
Unless he goes for the YOLO play. Nope, there goes the TP out.
Oh, he's already gone for enough YOLO plays. He knows after that T1 push mid that that is not the play. That is not the play, sir. Mid one.
Safety.
Almost got a duel on Ember.
Top lane. Keizu's in the neighborhood. Mid one. Maybe he does get it. He's looking at the defensive spirit. So the Centaur stomp to come in from the Dominator creep. That one belongs. And there's your duel. Units of farm. He has to Chronosphere and save his teammate's life for the relocate in. MP will do the work for Spirit away. Limp is still burning. He'll die to the Huskar. Units of farm. The TP out will be successful. Another ET stomp from EGM to create a little bit more space. But they relocate over, and MP knew where Loader was farming. That's why he's just legging it towards Loader. He's got the Hurricane Pint to close the distance. Now life break up. A quick steal on the Huskar into the stomp. He's going to be in a little bit of trouble underneath the tower. Pyline Eye, can he help him out? MP just stands his ground. Press the attack from mid one. The damage is just too much. Unison Farm will die too. Iron Mate loses life for the cause. Spirit comes forward. MP going to get stomped up. Nope, there's a four star.
I think it's actually worth trading the faces Void's Life Orb to Wisp to slow down this High Crown Siege. He didn't have Chronosphere anyway, so it's not the biggest deal. Is he going to actually hit the stun? MP does not even bother moving.
Well, he's got Negus the Immortal. He doesn't care.
He also got the shield off during the stomp, so it didn't really slow him down that much.
Like, he got to seal him up and then, like, fail him and then lose some beam. And still, he'll resist all your magical damage. So your only other choice is to move in close. Do physical damage. And the jump forward mid one's got the Blade Mail up and running. Couldn't get the duel he was looking for, however.
Oh,
he got sealed up so quickly. And okay, danger time. MP get away. Searing changes there. Keizu's got shields. Like, you've got Pylai die as well as an Abaddon behind him. MP can't die or shouldn't die. And he's almost finished the damn Satanic.
Man, having to use that Chronosphere top was so costly for them. They can just siege with impunity.
They needed a kill from it. And this siege, then this siege wouldn't have been happening, but there was no other choice. Well, they have 17 seconds. Trigger Lincoln Spear, that seems to be Poppy's job at the moment. Mr. I can move anywhere, now he's got his own fire remnants.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
MP takes the tower. And Team Secret, just in probably the fashion of game one, will move back and focus on the shrines now.
I don't think Luna was a pick.
I probably agree, but what other choice did you have?
Chaos Knight.
Like, CK was, yeah, maybe on the numbers.
I think Chaos Knight actually were pretty good here. Like, you could just destroy the Huskar. It's actually a pretty
I've got a feeling
pickup.
Alliance is just thinking, we just take one fight and then we move forward. Because CK doesn't synergize with the Faceless Void at all.
That's true. But you need some way to deal with the Huskar.
Smoke just broke. They know they're above. You kind of know it anyway because they were killing your shrine.
Yep. But they don't have the shrine up anymore. And I don't know if they want to take that fight. It could have been a good rune going the way of Team Secret too. Like a DD on MP. And that would have just ended the fight right there.
Yep.
And
Alliance are almost relying on TI4 right now. Chronosphere, Mystic Flare. But it doesn't kill off the primary core you want to kill.
Who do they kill with it? Just
It's Rubick.
Yeah,
that's it. You hope you get mid one before he gets Blade Mail up. So Skywrath Mage doesn't end up killing himself. And EGM is more of a backup. He's having the same kind of role as like an offlane Earthshaker support. If someone attacks, I'll just put my spirit out and stomp. They'll have to disengage, right? Hanskin's coming in. But you still got the IO. Pilot Eye is sitting here. He wants them to chrono. He wants them to engage an MP who is so close. There was only Bark separating these two. And do they do it? Chrono's up. Steeler's there. Pilot Eye starts to relocate. Can they get the stun? Oh, he got caught in the edge of the Chronosphere. Pylai dies, relocate got cancelled. He didn't pull him out. They lose the two. And the Lions have some breathing room.
He panicked. He tethered a tiny bit too early because they threw all the bursts that they had onto the Huskar. That was really good positioning by Alliance too. They even used a scan behind to see if Wisp was on the left side, and they just decided to go for it after it hit green. It's a big kill. Got to slow down this Huskar train.
Mm-hmm. And this allows Loda to start farming up into his BKB. A much-needed item for him in the fights. Even those Yule Scepters we were talking about before. Yeah, you got the Solar Crest on EGM, but look at the money. Up to 1,000 gold over on him. I'm seeing 1,500 on Hanskin, because he's the man that got the kill on MP. Pilot Eye went down to limp, but that was just over 500 gold into the bank of the Skywrath Mage.
The thing about Luna, though, is like, if she builds BKB, you still can't really run in with it. Like, Abba will still run at you, pretty much, put Curse of Avernus on you, mm-hmm. and just tank your Eclipse with the Borrowed Time, and then it still doesn't really protect you from the LC with Blink Blade Mail duel with the Abba sitting behind him.
Speaking of LC, okay, he'll blink away from the concussive shot. You got this small little battle. It's a battle. It's a purple and orange. Keeping tabs of who these little guys belong to. I believe they both belong. One belongs to the Luna. I think the other one. Where's the other one? Other one is the Abaddon. Yeah, so not the orange, it's the brown.
They look very similar on the mini.
Yeah, they really do. Especially for people who don't really struggle from colorblind.
Uh-oh.
There goes the tier 1 tower. Trade-off is for a tier 2.
He has Satana completed.
Yeah. I thought it was close, man. They fully done at 27 minutes.
The only way they can stop him from attacking is...
Chrono?
Chrono and Stomp. Those are not reliable ways to stop a Satanic.
They really are not. Is there anything else? Like
Yules is really good at dealing with it.
Yeah, they need that. But you don't have either Skyrath Mage or ET with the money yet for Yule Scepter. And it looks like the pressure is coming from Secret now.
ET's
the Faceless Void
close.
Is still farming up. He'll jump back now. And what do we get? It's a Blink Dagger Faceless Void. He's looking for the perfect Chronosphere if he can find it. And they're hoping they can keep Limp low, keep MP low.
A lot of fail-safes in terms of people getting caught out, though. They have Press the Attack on one and Aphotic Shield on the other, so you have to catch both those heroes if you want to be able to catch someone.
You even got Blink Glimmer over on Rubick now.
Oh, yeah.
That'll help you in everything apart from Chronosphere.
And he maxed Null Field. He went 2-4-4.
Wait, there's a Halberd? Okay.
Halberd's not that big a deal, though.
It's just a pain in the butt. Probably not as much unless this happens. Ember Spirit, there's a relocate over. Limp needs a spirit away. He fights a fist and he gets out.
That's the thing about Halberd. Some people really don't like Halberd because it doesn't synergize well with a blade mill. When you miss, you don't right click yourself. I don't think it would have mattered that particular fight, but generally people like damage.
You just have farm, use Timeless to get aggressive. Puppy's going to get the pickup on him. Potentially he can steal and keep going with it, but time dilation on the Keizu. MP right behind you, some farm. Another time lapse up in 1 second time, but MP has no stun. Try to use Life Break, but that only triggers Lincoln's Spear.
Roshan is up. Twilight Eye scouts it out.
It's the TP out that made us give him the confidence to go straight for this. Even though this is where Alliance were looking to fight. Like, Alliance wanted this. They have Chronosphere. They want to contest Roshan. And they're going to find out. This is Lotus Creep coming in right now. So they send in the Centaur Conqueror. One quick stun. They see the status of Roshan, and it's Legged. They have to move there quickly. Remember, you got the Blink plus the Leap Forward. If they want to get in, Roshan, 75 HP, it's already too late. They haven't found the opening. And it turns to Secret to be the aggressors and not Alliance now. Yeah, I'm not hearing. Oh. Yeah, you got to turn on, bro.
Kezu popped the smoke on that fight. He was standing on the bottom left. Right next to the Ancients, popped the smoke, and Yuan Zhongfan was like, I don't know if I can go in now. Mm-hmm. They didn't have any time to run any other direction, but just straight there. You're right, that TP kind of killed them, that fight. But, I don't know. You kind of had to do it, I guess. Wanted to play it safe rather than sorry. You could have TP'd back to the Shrine, that would have been the ideal play. Shrine up and then... Time walk in.
But then he'd be worried there'd be a dire observer all around just watching the movement.
Yeah. It would have been 3-4 seconds faster though, I think, which is kind of all they needed to actually think about contesting that Roche. So MP has how many lives? At least two with the Aegis, and then count Intervit and Satanic.
I think you gotta go for four.
Yeah, four sounds about right.
And if he gets that BKB completed, which he's working on at the moment. Like, he's a recipe away from having that thing done. Then life is almost completely over. And Abaddon is 1,000 gold away from Aghanim's.
How is he so farmed? Abba is as farmed as the Luna.
Yep. He's farming the top lane up at the moment with a Dark Troll Summoner.
Oh, yeah.
And before he was using the Satter, I think it was the Satter he had. So he was flash farming the waves with that. I say flash farming, he was just like prepping him and then hitting him perfectly.
There's no way for them to kill the Abba. Like, we talked about the Huskar having four lives or five with the BKB or whatever, but how'd they actually kill the Abba?
Good question.
He gets caught in everything, it doesn't matter. He has ulti, and then they don't have anything to follow up after that.
Even Puppy has a Lotus Orb. You got so much protection, you got double Glimmer Capes, you got Lotus Orb. Hurricane Pikes, Mech, Solar Crest, Satanic, Talbots to stop people from attacking if Lotus BKB goes down. Like, all these little things are just adding up to some massive ball that is the Team Secret lineup.
They're going for
and
the pick
you got
up
the Aegis of Satanic, and, well, can they actually get it? You know, some farm blink away. They need his ultimate, but the observer wall that's up here. Team Secrecy, everything. They won't get anything else. Meanwhile, Abaddon as well as Io die the front lines. Huskar is isolated. They can bring in the physical damage. Team Secret was split up, but MP, Satanic turns on. Lucid Beam will cancel the attack quickly, but the duel is up. It's over on Loda. The Chronosphere is down, combining with the Mystic Flare. The damage is enough. They get through one Huskar, still kept alive by Pilot Eye. The Searing Chains, the Lotus Orb, everything they've got to protect him. The Faceless Void will fall, and MP is still alive.
Didn't even lose Aegis. That was a great Chronosphere, too, by Jonas. He's getting all these great Chronos that's catching the enemies on the edge and keeping his teammates out so they can still right-click, but it is just not enough to stop this super-farmed Huskar.
The drop just seems impossible. Like, how do you stop this? EGM is going to go for the stomp, but a quick Hurricane Pike. MP, he doesn't want to leave. Like, he doesn't even have that many friends with him. But while he's got the Aegis to the Immortal, Alliance have to expend quite a fair amount for it, and that's why they're going. The Eclipse will be expended. Puppy is invis. Limp went out for him. Pilot Eye is ready to tether in and help out the Huskar, who is standing his ground. They still want to fight the back lines. Limp is just having his own personal war with the supports at the moment. But MP is having a war with buildings. He's playing PvE. He doesn't even see heroes on the map.
Objective Gaming at its finest.
Life raked in, jumps forward over towards Loda. Mystic Flare's doing its work, but Pilot Eye tethers forward, and now Satanic gets triggered. Loda will burn. He'll buy back quickly, and he'll need to. There's a lot of work to be done on this bottom lane. There's no fortification to protect them anymore, and they still need to kill off Huskar. They have a 20-second window before you have that Satanic back up again. But again, you also see that jump on the back lines. You know, some farm looking for the supports. Huskar is stranded on the front lines because if a Pilot die tethers in, he doesn't have enough. They got the kill, and now it's up to Alliance to make Secret pay. Take one, take two of the supports. Move over to Keizu. He doesn't have his ultimate available. This should be a kill as well. They are finding something to get back, but it's taken so much to achieve it.
They get a lot out of that. That's a lot of kills. Huskar, I definitely don't think he's falling off right now, but maybe if they can stall out for 10 minutes or so. I don't really know how they stall out that long, though. It's going to be pretty difficult for them.
Is this when you just start saying like you're going to get diminishing returns from every single push you've got?
But the base is exposed.
Yeah. I'm not saying it's going to be easy, but I'm still looking at the highest net worth, and Limp is catching up pretty quickly. The supports won't be able to survive for very long once Limp gets more and more farm, and that aid station, which is there for the Huskar when he's on the front lines, just won't exist anymore.
Oh, I know why he got the halberd. He got the halberd to pop the Lincolns so he can solo kill the LC and call in a relocate. That's actually a really good call by mid one. Well, he has a Shadow Blade scouting out for anyone. He might actually find Limp right here.
Yeah, he does, and it's the secretness. And then with the jump, no!
Oh my God.
Even get the relocate. He got away!
That was such fortunate timing for him. My God.
Limp
almost died.
Is a very happy man. That would have been a, like you potentially are staring down the barrel of either. He has the buyback available, but if you use your buyback on the Ember Spear at the moment, the game becomes even harder than it already is for Alliance.
Yep. Now they know he has a Shadow Blade. They can prep some Sentries, prep a gem perhaps. Ember Spirit actually getting a lot of farm now. Second highest net worth after this Huskar, but he does have his Blink Dagger to be even more elusive.
And the group up around the mid. Five heroes for Team Secret all together. Limp is still looking for any kind of farm he can get, pushing out the bottom lane. Where are you off to, Courier? It's got the Hyperstone. Oh no, the Hyperstone! Goodbye, Courier! Load of illusions! No, it missed uphill! Courier lives. Lucky duck.
They just have the regular Donkey Courier.
Yeah, they do.
They have something way more baller.
I'm sorry, this is Team Secret budget cuts. Like, you're not allowed nice things now.
Man. That's so sad. Every time I see a normal donkey, I'm like, I know they have some sweet couriers.
where they're just hiding
in
them
in their inventory.
The secret couriers.
Well, it's actually Puppy who buys the courier, right? So
is it? Maybe Puppy just hates cosmetics.
Well, Pilot, he has some items. He's
yeah, look at
that.
This like he's got like almost the basic Rubik set. Maybe this is his Smurf. Is this competitive Smurf that doesn't have any items?
I'm not sure. That might actually be the case.
Lim set it up towards the top lane. They may start using Faceless Void as a little bit of bait. Mid one's already moving over like he wants it, but Unison Farm blinks into the tree line. This is such a bait.
They have a gem.
Jump forward. They see him. Legion Commander, the relocate's coming in. The Chronosphere! It got Rubik as well as Keizu, and the Splitter will be right on the money, catching out the Huskar as well with the Eclipse. Rubik is one last hit away. He'll get a little bit more life back from Abaddon, but it's not going to be enough. So Puppy with the first one to go down. The Mass Abilities already triggered. The Life Break. MP just jumps forward, taking out Hanskin. EGM as well as Unison Farm are over on the run. EGM tries to create space, but it's time to duel. With a relocate over, Limp wants murder. He wants Pylai die, but what he wants, he can't have.
That's a gem down, too. That was a good trap that they tried to spring for the Legion Commander. Very well attempted by Alliance right there. They got the Mystic Flare out on the Legion Commander, but he was very quick with his pressed the attack. Stopped the slow and just casually walked out of it because the Chronosphere was dedicated to the two heroes on the side.
So no Chronosphere for 55 seconds. ET Stomp and Limp Harassment is the only thing that's going to keep this creep wave off the top. And Unison Farm's making the most out of it. He knows what he needs. He needs the Aghanim Scepter, and he has the money for it now. But it would sacrifice his buyback to get it. But he needs the lower cooldown timer on the Chronosphere.
Yep, he bought it out.
He needed to. There's just no choice, right?
There is no choice right now.
MP, jump forward, the Searing Chains limped out a very long way. They're trying to force some level of reaction from anybody. The chip away at the supports. Keizu having to shield himself up, can't just shield the Husker who runs in. So keep the spirit damage on him. Puppy looking for the Searing Chains, they don't really find it. Just press the attack, doing his work, and they're actually protecting Limp. He's got the double Lincoln Sphere on him at the moment. Not certain who the second one actually is. Alright, so it is Faceless Void giving his Lincoln Sphere over to Limp.
Chronosphere has finally come off cooldown. This is it. Right here.
But you don't have Eclipse. 25 seconds. You need 25 seconds for Eclipse as well.
They have like Null Field and Glimmers. I think that they need a big Earth Splitter to end the fight.
There's your TP down bottom.
It'd be such a shame to see Alliance go so far in the playoffs only to fall short to their earlier opponent.
Never give up. Never surrender. And always smoke up a high ground. It's not the story I remember. Puppy's playing King of the Hill at the moment. As Husker leaps in, he looks towards Loda. Time dilation trying to help him out, but the duel has already begun and EGM is gone. They needed his aura. Limp also in very deep. It's almost like they have these objectives. Limp has to kill off Pylai Dai.
EGM has prepared for this with the minus respawn timer. He's up at 20.
Is this actually the play? Dire's bottom tower is under it's attack. Hilarious that this is actually the effigy of Loda, the hero that they didn't pick that you wanted them to pick, and exactly the what they might have to do to try and win this game. But they still haven't brought down the tier 1 tower in mid. So going for throne is difficult to say the least. 25,000 net worth over on the Huskar. The overall advantage is not that huge for Team Secret. In fact, experience-wise, Alliance are winning on that front.
Hardly matters, I would say. Luna really needs Butterfly to be able to do some damage in these team fights.
Why do they keep giving this to MP? Isn't he the immortal one anyway?
He's a tower hitter.
But they gave him the Aegis as well as the cheese.
Who else is going to hit the tower? Middle one's certainly not going to hit the tower. He's just going to sit in the back, look for a good duel, and press the attack, the Huskar. So it definitely should go on the Huskar. Yeah, he's limited on slots, but he is what this entire game is centered around.
The Huskar.
Yep.
If Huskar wins, you win.
No treads, just straight ball and walking up that hill.
Is that really? Don't need attack speed when you got Pylite Eye.
Alliance, they need a hold here. They need to prevent the Abba from getting off his ulti, though.
Top lane. Relocate's coming in, but that's a little too late. Limp's already back home. And Unison Farm's very happy about that. Reveals the position, allows him to just pressure the bottom lane in a little bit more. I wonder if he gets to a point where he just has to start hitting away at the tier 1 tower in mid. If no one comes to defend the bottom lane,
he can creep skip, but he doesn't hit very hard. So.
Yeah, he needs like Maelstrom in order to creep skip, but he's building into the Mantis Isle at the moment. MP. Okay, here they come. Team Secret, they want the Rax. They'll have to go through Fortification this time around. Range Rax won't mean enough to Alliance to use it on that. Just a quick stomp, try and create a little bit of space as again Limp into the back lines of Team Secret as Presti attacks mid one, or he flags the warning bells of the impending duel. Limp out again. Pick up, Puppy's got him. Can he actually get it? No, the stomp is keeping them asleep, and now Loader lets the Eclipse go. He needs to survive. MP's doing the physical damage from behind, but they do get a 2-for-1 trade-off. It's Loader's sacrifice. Will it be enough? Maybe with a Chronosphere, they can turn around the Mystic Flare. It's on the Abaddon, but the ulti, now in comes Pylight Eye. They get through Abaddon. They're moving on to MP. MP's losing life. Aegis Immortal will bring him to life, but unfortunately, when he comes back to the world of the living, he has no friends. They are all dead. There's your stomp. Life break forward. They burn through him. The physical damage. A quick cheese charge. EGM. He's still alive. He might burn. No, he lives on 6 HP. And Team Secret lose the whole enchilada.
Another great Chronosphere delivered by Ionism Fan. That stomp from EGM saved that fight so hard. Telekinesis into the duel. That was the plan from Secret. And they were right about to duel the Ember Spirit. Right about to. You could taste that plus 18 damage. And then he got stomped, and then the whole fight just went to crap.
They just look so tired having that nap on bottom lane.
They need a BKB on LC.
They
that,
do.
That would have saved them that fight.
And you can see it in the quick buy now. Yeah, mid one recognizes
like,
it. Enough of this Lincoln Sphere trigger stuff.
It's also because Limp has been playing amazingly well and has not been caught out by the Shadow Blade or the Blink into the Halberd into the duel. That is a very common way for Ember Spirits to die, but amazingly, Limp has not died to any of these side ganks, which is incredible. And he's keeping the lanes pushed out at the same time, too, so he's not playing like a complete wuss.
Yeah.
And he's almost six slotted.
The power of the Ember Spirit. And thanks to the double damage the Loader was able to pick up, this push becomes a lot more efficient. They got through the tier 1 tower, and they're beating the backdoor regeneration. Alpha Wolf plus double damage. They won't force it. Actually, they force out of fortification. The Team Secret probably believe now with the Huskar up, Alliance will retreat, and they'll look more towards Roshan. They have lanes to repair, even though the melee Rax in the mid is the only big one they've lost. Yes, you've lost your range racks on bottom, and the mid one is almost gone as well. But it works.
When you get a fight like that, yes, it certainly does. Melee racks still holding up strong in the bottom lane.
So Unison Farm is now changing his mind for items. So he already has the Aghanims with the Mantisnile and Lincoln Spheres. So there's a lot of survivability. His next target is actually Amplification / Control. There's no BKB on a Huskar. Once the BKB goes down on the Husker for timing, maybe the Bloodthorn will be more useful.
Wow, I thought he was actually going for a Refresher.
Yeah, it's not Refresher. He's gone Bloodthorn. Ember Spirit, the duel, the Lincoln, it triggers it! How much damage have you got, however, with a relocate? The Chronosphere! It'll hold him there, the duel will be wasted, and he can Spirit himself away to safety after Sleight of Fist. All the way home, the saving Chrono. Luckily, thanks to Aghanim Scepter, there's more where that came from.
And Unison Fan, you remember that top fight that Ember Spirit died to? I think he realized that he should have just Chronosphere on top, because Ember can just immediately Remnant afterwards, and he should be okay.
Oh, MP's coming to fight. Like, no, there's no Chronosphere. Alliance don't want to be here. Observer Ward gets planted down so they can see it. Push up. Unison Farm, not certain he really wanted to time walk his way forward into that one. He can do it again and just jump away. Repairs a large portion of the damage, but bought enough time with distraction for Alliance to get back home. 13 seconds.
That's enough.
Yep. A fresh Hurricane Pike on Loader, so he's got more maneuverability that he can work around with. And EGM, he's very used to doing this. Normally he's used to working with the Naga Siren, so you send Naga Illusions plus the Spirit up the mid, and you take out the creep wave before it even reaches the base.
this game just got really tense after that. Gold lead evaporated to about 2,500 just in favor of Secret. Huskar has peaked out. He is close to 6 slotted, I suppose. Can start swap the armlet out for something else.
It begs the question, how many pushes have Secret got in them? Like, yeah, the Raxes are exposed, but...
Another 5-0, and I... or 5-1 even, then I think Alliance will likely take this just because I think they have really good high ground defense. Actually, maybe once LC gets PTE, but LC's not even farming that well. LC had like 1,000 gold last time I checked, and that was 3-4 minutes ago. Now he's only at 1,800 gold after that botched
attempt
on top.
Mid one's duty is to find the Ember. It's a Lincoln's trigger into a kill.
Oh, they're actually playing on the offensive. Jonas and Fan is set up on the side as they try and smoke in.
Are they going to do this? Are they going to catch Team Secret out of position? Thanks to the Observer Ward, which was just got dewatered by Puppy, they won't have this vision. The TP4 with the BTs, Unison Farm, the target. You think it might just be an Ember defending the lane. He jumps forward, misses the Searing Chains over on MP, but still wants to keep moving forward. The Stomp is not enough. The Hurricane Pike, now they'll get it. Puppy jumps in, triggers the Lincoln Spear so they can jump forward. Defensive Spirit out. Hanskin is keeping the Legion Commander at bay, and Loader is turning around. I think they've realized his Spice Winds are too many different parts. Now with the Mystic Flare, Hanskin's killing himself on the back of the Blade Mail. Not to mention Loader just can't tank that type of damage. The ET Splitter needs to create space, pulling it back in again. Legion is finally down, but MP having all the time in the world to start stacking up these Burning Spears. This is not the fight Alliance were looking for. They need to retreat. They don't have Loader. Limp is doing his work. Any kills he can claim will create more breathing room and maybe stop Secret from pushing into the base.
That was a buyback expended on the LC, so any dreams of BKB are going to be dashed, and Limp is still quite strong. He was able to take out two heroes in that fight. Chronosphere was not used at all during that fight, so Jonas Fan still has that in his tool. MP, he does have enough for buyback BOTs, I believe, in case he dies in this fight. And can they stall? That is the question.
Well, MP's coming forward, and Limp will do as much damage as he can to keep the creep wave out and the backdoor regeneration in place.
They get
with the
duel
scepter, the duel is out. With the Chronosphere, it catches a Badness as well as Legion Commander. Ember Spirit, now the Mystic Flare. Have they got enough damage? Ember back into the Slide of Fist, but Unison Farm, he's on the wrong side of the tracks, but maybe he's okay with this. He's still got Time Walk, and he's delaying time. 33 seconds until Luna is up. You did lose the Ember, but buyback is available.
Ember tried a Shrine, but actually was just a tad bit away from the Shrine. He does have his buyback available. Are they gonna try and save this melee Rex?
Time dilation, time walk up, get away. They're letting it go by the looks of it.
Wow, he's actually saving his buyback too, just waiting for Luna to hold, but he might have to buyback at the end of the day. Anyways, as MP storms and Taste Megas.
He has no choice, like he has to buyback now.
Yeah, but
it's just the Luna. Like, until Luna is up, you're not going to feel confident coming out as a team. And until Team Secret really show their intention to take this off Rax, which now MP is doing, there was also no other point. So they start their attack, and MP will jump away. Limp able to get the Searing Chains off. Unison Farm, he's got that Chronosphere waiting and ready to go. But Puppy, thanks to that Lotus Orb onto the Huskar, makes it difficult to keep the disable up. And Hanskin knows it. So they jump forward, they find a different target. It's Pylai Dai, a quick Manta. The duel begins, but it's not on a real one. Or is it? The duel is out, and maybe Unison Farm can tank this up. He jumps forward and gets a Chronosphere in the back lines. Both supports are caught. Legion Commander is down, but MP is not controlled. Unison Farm, he still wants Pylai Dai, and he'll claim him. Move his attention over towards Puppy, the captain of Team Secret. He's retreating out, but this... Well, they just have a Vendetta. No support from Team Secret is allowed to survive. But I'm watching the Huskar inside the base, chasing down Hanskin. A Shrine will keep him alive. But where are the friends? Limp will come in. It's the damage from MP looking to kill off Limp. He's slowed down so much, Limp. He spirits away, but he won't have the life to survive. 35, he'll tick out. 2 minutes without him. With no Luna, they have no real cause to do the damage. MP may just be enough to carry it through. One more fight potentially could have done it. Hanskin's throwing everything he's got, but it's an ultra kill for the Huskar, and it may be more. They're going in deep into the tier 4 towers, keeping Alliance back at their fountain. Unison Farm is just ticking down with so many Burning Spears on him. The Stomps are just delaying the inevitable. Alliance will fight to the bitter end. One Chrono is left. They'll catch out two. EGM caught on the edge of that one too. So is Keizu. He's close enough that maybe, yeah, they get through the Rubick. but buyback is there. Puppy will come back to the world of the living, and Team Secret, they're taking everything from Alliance.
I have never seen a Huskar buffed up by so many different things in one game. It's like a constant string of Lotus Orbs, a Aphotic Shield, just everything dumped on top of him.
GG.
And he is unstoppable.
This game is over. Good game, well played. Team Secret will be the team to represent Europe at the Kiev Major. Alliance fought hard and valiantly. But at the end of the day, they got Huskar'd. They almost survived the Huskar, but it was too much.
This is why you probably have to ban Wisp every time against Secret, because they have so many different strategies, and Puppy pulling deep into his pool to eke this one over Alliance. And what better way to try it than when you're 1-0 up? And it looked a little bit dicey at times, but the structural damage coming out from MP, his damage had to have been incredible that game, but it was four heroes buffing him up.
Yeah,
that was truly a four protect.
He did 70,000, almost 71,000 damage in the entire game.
Limp played his heart out.